Hey, Liam Ward here at LearnTheHarmonica.com. Today we're going to be learning On the Road Again by Canned Heat on an A harmonica. Don't go anywhere. If you enjoyed today's lesson, please click like and subscribe to my channel. Hit that notification bell to get a free harmonica lesson every single week. So in today's YouTube lesson, I'm going to be teaching you the solo from On the Road Again by Canned Heat. It's a really cool solo played by Alan Wilson, also called the Blind Owl, who famously, John Lee Hooker said he couldn't lose him. He used to try and lose musicians, play with them and mess with them, and Alan just kept up with him. Great player, died too young like a lot of harmonica players did, and he played a really cool solo with something very distinctive, and you might have heard this or you might not have noticed this really cool thing about this solo, so I'm going to tell you all about it. All will be revealed. If you'd like to learn the full song, and there is more to it, there's an intro and there's a kind of solo towards the end of the song, then do check out my premium lesson, which is available via the link below this video. And if you enjoy my premium lessons, then consider becoming a member of my website, which gives you free access to all of my harmonica lessons, all the premium lessons and tabs, for $19.99 a month. And you get 2 months free if you join as a yearly member right now. Okay, so let's get on with the solo. What I'm going to do is put the record on so we can hear it full speed, and then I'm going to slow it down and talk about it line by line. So I'll get the tune up, and here we go into the solo. That is such a cool solo, and there's something really surprising which I'm going to reveal when we get to it. You might have an inkling of what's going on there, but you may not. It might surprise you. So let's get on with the first line. I'm going to slow it down, and it sounds like this. Bear in mind, by the way, he's come out of just playing a little lick, a kind of turnaround lick out of the verse. So that's why there's a little bit of overlap. So let's get right at the start on line A. Okay. Did you notice something really weird there? There's actually a note which is impossible to get on a normal harmonica, or at least without a special technique. So, we've got... and then the next note... isn't there! And then... okay, so we've got a three-draw semitone bend, and then he plays a four-blow, but I think he actually slides up to it. So I've written one blow, slide up to four, so... like that, and then four draw, five draw, six blow. So far, so good. The next note is the equivalent of the six overblow. Now, I have it on good authority that the Blind Owl himself didn't overblow. It would have been, there are examples of overblows earlier than Canteet's recordings, but it would have been pretty kind of futuristic of him to be overblowing. But I've heard, and you know, maybe give me your comments in the video comments if you'd like to sort of join the debate, but my understanding is that he retuned his harmonica so that the sixth draw would give him that note rather than having to overblow. So he'd take that sixth draw note and move it up a semitone so he'd get that missing note. So I think that's how he was getting it. You could overblow it or you could sing it. I actually wondered at first if he was singing that note, just going... which you could do, you know, and with the distortion of a microphone and an amp, it would kind of cover that a little bit, so it could kind of work. That was the overblow, if you were to overblow it. But, yeah, my understanding is that he would actually tune his sixth draw up a semitone, which if he did, was really cool and creative. Does mean you then don't have that sixth draw note if you wanted that, but that's okay. If you don't want to overblow, if you don't want to sing the note, if you don't want to retune your harmonica, you could just play the sixth draw, but it won't give you the same note. Of course, it'll be a semitone down. So after that note, it kind of slides down to the four draw. So if you have a six draw that's retuned, what you can do with that is bend that down, and you can bend it back down to what it would normally be, the normal six draw note, and then you can slide down to the four draw. Like that. Imagine it's higher. And slide down. So if you ever wondered, if you tried working it out and couldn't get what he was playing, then that's what's going on there, or at least that's my understanding of it. I'm sure it's always the case when I put anything contentious on YouTube, someone tells me they know better than me. But, you know, let me know. What do you think? So that's our opening line. And then he kind of does the same thing again with line B, finishes it off differently, but let's have a listen. Okay, I skipped on and heard a bit of line C then, but let's go back to line B. So we've got... So we're going the same all the way up to that mystery note, and then I think this is maybe the giveaway that he was retuning it up, because he sounds like to me he bends down from that kind of note, the missing note, to what would be the normal six draw note. Now I can overblow that note and then play the six draw, but I can't bend between them because one is an overblow and the other's a draw note. So I think he's playing the note and then bending it down to what would be the normal six draw note, because that is now a bend note on his retuned six draw. And I think that's what I'm hearing, which is kind of what, you know, makes it sound like he's retuned it. So you've got that kind of retuned note, bends down to the six draw, and then six blow, five draw, five blow, four draw bend, four blow. So, and then it continues on into line C. The way I've split up the lines is, I was going to say arbitrary. I've tried to make it sensible so that they're not too long and they're kind of, you know, bite-sized chunks. But line B and C kind of run together because it's quite a long phrase. So line C, I've got three draw semitone bend, two draw full step bend, one draw bend, one draw. Okay. And then a couple more lines to go. This is line D. Okay, so we've got... So that first section is, I really like this bit. So he's got a two draw full step bend that releases kind of up to the middle of the, like a semitone bend, and then back down again. And then a one draw. I really like it when someone does that, kind of up and down, lowest bend to the middle bend, down to the lowest bend again. And then he almost repeats that, but he doesn't come back down, so he's going just releasing it a little bit, and then to the one draw. It does that four times. So you've got once and then. Four times and then just one blow, one draw. And then just to finish the solo, I've just got a couple more notes. So just two draw, full step bend, and then two draw twice. So that is the solo from On The Road Again. I have done a premium lesson on the full song, the single version. There's actually, I found at least two different versions. There's a longer version, which I think kind of waffles on a bit and goes on too long. I think the version that I believe was released as a single is the nicest, concisest one. But there's an intro, there's kind of a bit of rhythm playing, and there is another a short solo towards the end of the song as well. If you want to learn all of that, then check out the link beneath the video to my premium lesson. And if you're enjoying my premium lessons, you can become a member of my website, which gives you access to all of my premium lessons and tabs. And it's a growing collection because I'm putting up a new one every single week. And that's just $19.99 a month. Or if you sign up for a yearly membership right now, then you can save 2 months absolutely free. I hope you've enjoyed looking at this with me today. Do remember to click like and subscribe to my channel. Click the notification bell to get a free harmonica lesson every single week and support my channel and help it grow. Thank you very much, and I'll see you again soon. Cheers.